Welcome back. I'll continue to talk about cones in the diagnostic block in chronic pain. The somatic structures were considered a culprit of chronic low back pain in the past, and the neuropathic component was a minor contributor. But the high proportion of neuropathic pain components was verified and reported higher than expected. The painDETECT questionnaire is a symptom-based assessment tool developed to identify neuropathic pain and became a notable instrument for screening on neuropathic pain. The authors used the painDETECT screen questionnaire to measure the neuropathic pain component in chronic low back pain patients. According to their study, neuropathic pain was detected in about 20% and pure somatic pain was considered 53%. Denervation procedure possibly only destroys sensory nerves without improving symptoms in 20% of neuropathic chronic back pain patients. How about the RF neurotomy indication? If you review most published journals regarding the RF facet joint procedure, the recipient were young. According to their meta-analysis, most studies reported chronic lumbar facet joint pain. Patients' ages of RF neurotomy group were from 41 years to 65 years. Is it too young? How about the effectiveness of RF in chronic spinal pain? One Cochrane review analyzed the RCTS of RF denervation on a positive patients with a double comparative block. It shows that moderate evidence suggests that facet joint RF denervation has a more significant effect on pain than placebo over short term. Low-quality evidence indicates that facet joint RF denervation is more effective than placebo for function over the short-term and long-term. For discogenic pain, RF denervation did not improve the symptom. When the RF denervation is used for SI joint pain, low-quality evidence reveals no difference from placebo in effect on pain. The review authors found no high-quality evidence suggesting that RF denervation provides pain relief for chronic low back pain patients. There is no convincing evidence to show that this treatment improves function. Let me explain more about the functional system. In terms of spinal function, the good core back muscle is regarded as an essential foundation for the stability of the lumbar spine. We don't know which exercise can facilitate the deep muscle without hurting damaged disc or facet joints, but I'm sure the deep back muscle is a subject to train and strengthen, not destroy. Any exercise therapy is not more effective for acute low back pain than inactive treatment. It is obvious that acute pain originates from the injured tissue, but active exercise after acute episode can reduce the recurrence rate on a second attack in 1 and 3 years. There is a conflicting evidence on the effectiveness of exercise therapy compared to inactive treatment for chronic low back pain. Exercise therapy was more effective than usual care by the general practitioners and just as effective as conventional physiotherapy for chronic low back pain. There are many reports of multifidus denervation by middle branch thermal radiofrequency. The multifidus muscle is one of the cores of segmental stability, and segmental instability has been proven in chronic pain patients. The multifidus muscle is inhibited in the acute stage of pain and progress to fibrosis, fatty degeneration, and eventually muscle atrophy. Stability is storing capacity into a neutral position. For example, if this boat were constructed in a good balance, the ship would stay safe in a strong storm. Biomechanical term instability means the inability to restore to a neutral position and make balance. I can visualize the spinal instability by sustained flexion and extension image in a moderate to severe cases. Let me explain more about stability in the joint. First, stability is maintained by the passive and active systems. The passive system comprises a bony structure, ligament, joint capsule, and discs. The active control system consists of muscle components and neural components. The muscle and tendons look more critical to make stability than the neural control system, but I think the neural control system is more important. The neural control system consists of sensory, central integration, and motor system. The sensory component is essential as the motor nerve. The active muscle component and neural control system are working together. Let me review the muscular stabilization of the lumbar spine. The global muscle like rectus abdominis and erector spinae contributes one component. The local muscles like transverse abdominis and multifidus have been proven more critical component of segmental stabilizers. The diaphragm and pelvic floor muscle contribute to the muscular stabilizer of the lumbar spine. There are functional impairment in chronic spinal pain. Atrophy of deep back muscles. Biopsy changes in deep back muscles. Reduced muscular strength and endurance. Reduced sensory motor control of the back. Reduced function of the tonic stabilizing muscles. There is much evidence of muscular involvement in acute and chronic spinal pain. One study shows decreased localized reduction of cross-sectional area of multifidus during acute pain. When the low back pain persists, back muscle structure changes become more extensive. Medial branch radiofrequency denervation destroys the muscular and sensory branches of the facet and core muscles. There is a possible complication of RLF neurotomy, post-neurotomy neuropathy. In some cases, the incidence was reported up to 19%. Diagnostic blocks are needed to confirm the pain generator, but no one nerve supplies a single structure. In addition, the medial branch block cannot exclude myofascial or ligamentous pain generators over posterior spinal structures. Therefore, a very cautious approach is needed. There are many articular branch anatomic studies targeting denervation procedure, but we must accept that there are also flaws in their studies. The denervation procedure damages motor and sensory nerves, which are essential for maintaining homeostasis. Currently, most people live longer than 80 years. Diagnostic block and concurrent RLF denervation procedures could be unethical if you select patients in a group of too young age and neuropathic pain. Thank you for watching. See you in the following videos.